All right, Coach, I tell you what, this season doesn't open up any more difficult than coming to Yulman Stadium.
Yeah. You know, these are the moments that you, as a competitor, right, you get really excited for. As a fan base, it's an awesome opportunity for our fans to be able to come and show up. It's going to be a packed stadium. It's going to be a very talked about game, one of the best group of five matchups in college football going into week one of the season. And this is what you play and coach the game for. And so, something that we're really excited about, when you build championship programs and you have great moments, you have to play in games like this and want to compete at the highest level.
Talk to me. Will we perhaps see P.J. Martin come home for a homecoming and play?
Well, I think P.J. is doing some pretty tremendous things already as a freshman. You know, you look at just his ability. As an athlete with the ball in his hand, he does some really special things. He's got great instincts, great vision, but he's also, you know, he just came in, he's already going to work, and whether he plays immediately or a little bit down the road, I would imagine he's going to have a pretty tremendous career with us.
What is it about PJ that makes him such an outstanding back? And also, how did you guys land him?
Yeah, you know, PJ is one of those cases, right, in high school athletics where, you know, the transfer portal probably had an effect on things. He was a little bit of a late bloomer, late developer, just in terms of his body and frame. But he's so instinctive, and he's got such great vision, and he runs with such decisiveness and physicality that he's really the total package. I mean, when you look at the running back position and how he's going to develop over the next year here into becoming, I think, has an opportunity to be one of the best backs in the league moving forward. Learning from guys like LaDainian Webb that are going to walk out the door, and Marco Lee, and then, you know, a young man like him is going to have to step into the stage.
How did you guys land him?
Yeah, you know, I think we do a great job of recruiting and building relationships, but probably more importantly, we do a good job of evaluating, right? And particularly guys in their senior year that we've recognized, some traits and things that we want to see how they develop into their senior year. And PJ was a perfect example of that, of just finding ways, right, to make sure that we're evaluating the right people and then showing them why we think that they're such a great person and what they're capable of. And I think that's ultimately what sold him.
What does it say about your program and what you're developing in South Alabama that you guys are already on the map for young stars like PJ Martin and others?
Yeah, you know, I think the ceiling for South Alabama can be very high, right? And a lot of that is going to become when we can maximize the talent in the Gulf South, right? From New Orleans to Tallahassee and Mobile and Alabama, Mississippi. You know, we really narrow our scope. We don't go too far, but we don't have to go very far. We've got to find creative ways to make sure we show the vision of what these young men can accomplish right in their backyards. And I think PJ's a perfect example of that. And hopefully, right, what he does over his next 4 years at South Alabama leads the way for the next group of New Orleans players to come and live out their dreams in Mobile.
And when you think about the Sun Belt, you think about teams like South Alabama. We talked earlier, Southern Miss, those guys coming in to the conference. What does it say about the Sun Belt that it's almost old school college football again?
Yeah, you know, this the Sun Belt is as competitive of a league as there is in Group of Five athletics right now, and particularly in football. You know, it's a very healthy conference from top to bottom. You've shown that there's players that may have finished at the bottom of the rankings, but have knocked off teams at the top of the rankings. And I think that's indicative of a very healthy conference, but also a really difficult and tough conference week in and week out that you got to be ready to navigate.
Now, speaking of the conference, and we talked about Southern Miss, how tough is it for you when you have to coach against your old school?
Well, you know, I don't lack for motivation, you know what I mean, to beat my alma mater, if that's what you're asking. You know, I had great times at Southern Miss, both as a player and a student. My dad had a tremendous career, as you know, at Southern Miss as the defensive coordinator back in those nasty bunch defenses. But it's really special to be able to walk back into that stadium like we did last year and have the nostalgia in those deals. And at the end of the day, you got to go get after an opponent. And so that's really fun to be able to do that.
Thank you so much, Coach. I appreciate
it. Thanks. I appreciate it. It was good.
Thank you.
Enjoyed that.
Thank you.